Okay, so, I mean, it looks like we're going to get a vaccine by the end of December.
What?
This COVID-19 vaccine thing is on. It's happening, and way sooner than we all expected. I wonder if I can stop hand sanitizing every second of every day. Yes. If you're like me, you have a lot of questions about the vaccine. Thankfully, I know who to ask. See, I talked to Alyson Kelvin about vaccines in 2019, way before COVID-19 was even a thing. Back when I was doing interviews in crowded places.
For Halloween. Oh my God, the fact that we're in a store and not wearing masks.
Back when we were sharing equipment.
Right here, I'm putting on a VR headset that probably a bunch of other people have put on, and someone's helping me put it on there.
And back for when I thought I was going away for March break 2020.
Hey guys, it's Isabelle. On March break, I'm going away to Mexico.
No, you're not.
Last time we spoke, you were talking to me about the measles vaccine, and today I wanted to talk about the vaccine for COVID-19. How soon will Canadian kids be able to get the vaccine?
The way the vaccine has been prioritized here in Canada, it seems that, you know, people who are more vulnerable, who are older, and as well as healthcare workers, people who might be exposed to the virus for their job, they have been put as people who are going to be first for getting the vaccine. So at this point, we'll have to wait for more data to really have a more concrete answer of when this vaccine will, or vaccines will be available for children.
And this vaccine is like so new. So how can we know that it works?
Well, there's human clinical trials, meaning people sign up to be part of the testing of this vaccine. And there's been over 30,000 to 40,000 people who have signed up to use themselves to test the vaccine. The results are showing that the vaccine was able to stop people who were given the vaccine from getting the disease. So that's how we know that the vaccine is working.
So you're a vaccine researcher. How confident are you that this vaccine is safe?
So the vaccine has been tested in thousands and thousands of people and have shown no significant safety concerns. So because it's been given to so many people and they haven't had a problem, I think that you can feel safer getting this vaccine, knowing that no problems have been recognized so far.
Some of my friends have told me that they're not even sure that they want to get the vaccine. What should I tell them?
I think it's completely understandable to be nervous just even getting a vaccine. No one likes getting needles, but we know that the vaccine is going to help protect us against being infected with this virus, and hopefully it's going to help stop the spread of the virus. And I think Health Canada has really shown that they are reviewing the safety of these vaccines to the smallest detail, which I think is really important and has given me confidence that I want to get the vaccine.
How soon after we get vaccinated can we stop wearing masks and physical distancing?
Unfortunately, we're not going to have enough doses of COVID-19 vaccines immediately for everybody who wants them in the country, which means that we'll have to continue to keep up our social and physical distancing practices, as well as wearing masks, until we can see the COVID-19 numbers really drop. I'm feeling very optimistic that we will be able to get out of the majority of this pandemic in the next year, that we will be able to stop the community transmission, and I will be able to go watch my daughter Chloe play soccer, and I'm really excited about that.
Well, sounds like I can't chuck the hand sanitizer just yet. For more on the COVID-19 vaccine, check out cbckidsnews.ca. For CBC Kids News, I'm Isabelle MacNeil.